We'll leave it at that. Thanks a lot for getting us the highlights of this all-important roadshow conducted by Citi. Let's talk technicals right now. Welcoming in Ruchit Jain from Angel Broking on the show. Hi, Ruchit. Good morning. Let's straight talk about Nifty and the levels that you are projecting and the ones that we can look forward to.
Hi. Well, if you see the recent past, then the Nifty and the Bank Nifty index has given a breakout from a consolidation phase during mid-July. In last 1 month, we have seen a continuous series of higher top, higher bottom structure, and probably this week started on a weak note owing to this global negative cues. But we believe that there are no signs of reversal yet. The index heavyweight still continues to be show positive sign, and hence this corrective move, we are seeing this corrective move as just a correction within an uptrend. So positional traders should in fact use this decline as a buying opportunity. On the Nifty front, 20-day exponential moving average is coming around 11,255 to 11,280 range. So any further dips towards this 11,255, 11,280 range should then be used as a buying opportunity. We are not advising to go in any shorts because the broader trend for the markets is still positive, and one should hence trade in the direction of the trend rather than going against the trend.
Okay, let's talk about individual stocks, Richard. And naturally, the weakness in the rupee is something that's going to have its concomitant effect on IT stocks. And it was no wonder that we saw Tech Mahindra topping the charts yesterday in trade. What's your view on IT stocks and more specifically Tech Mahindra?
Post the weakness seen in the rupee yesterday, you know, most of the IT stocks have again came back to momentum after a consolidation phase. Even the Nifty IT index post a long consolidation phase of about a month had again showed a positive traction in yesterday's session. Now, if we see Tech Mahindra, then broadly the 89 EMA has again acted as a support for Tech Mahindra, and yesterday's action, a positive, a pullback move from that support is a positive sign. So in near term, we should see some more pullback. 688 would be the first resistance level for Tech Mahindra to watch out for. And in case we see stock going above 688, then 705 could also be seen on the charts. So existing positions with long positions, existing long positions in the system should be held on in Tech Mahindra with stop loss placed below 638.
Also talking about how OMCs are likely to be impacted by this big concern. How are you seeing a VPCL on the charts? What's the move that one can expect there?
VPCL has been forming this low top, low bottom structure since last few months. Although recently we had seen a pullback move, but again, if we observe the daily chart, then on every pullback move in last few months, 89 EMA on the daily chart had acted as a resistance for VPCL. Similar was the case during last week also. The stock was not able to cross that resistance. And again, yesterday's trading session seen that prices have resumed this corrective phase. So we could see a broad consolidation phase in VPCL now in the range of 360 to 400. And since prices have corrected from the resistance end of the range, it could slide further towards 360, 365 in next few trading sessions. So clearly, you know, OMC, specifically VPCL, should be avoided from a short-term trading perspective.
And of course, do remember both of these are currency sensitive sectors and currency sensitive stocks. But Richard, moving away from those, let's talk about your two recommendations. What is it that traders and investors could watch out for when trade opens this morning for profitable ideas?
So a couple of buy recommendations. One is from the IT space. We already spoke about how the IT index has seemed to have shown a positive traction post a consolidation phase of about a month. HCL Tech is one of the stock in which in yesterday's trading session showed an up move supported by good volumes. The stock is on the verge of breakout from a falling trendline resistance. Although yes, within the larger space in there, within the heavyweight IT space, HCL Tech has been one of the underperformer in the recent past. But we believe that going ahead, it should show a catch up rally, and HCL Tech should show an up move. So at current levels, one can go long with stop below 955, expecting short-term targets around 1040 to 1050. And my second call is a buy call in Amara Raja Batteries. The only caveat is this is a conditional call because the stock has closed dead below its breakout level. The breakout is placed above 840, whereas yesterday's closing was around 830 levels. So if whenever we see a breakout above 840, maybe tomorrow, today or tomorrow's trading session, in case we see a breakout above 840, trader should create a long position above 840, keeping stop loss below 805. We should expect a very sharp up move above 840 for target projections towards 895 to 900.
Okay, Richard, so let you go on that. Thanks a lot for joining us with your perspective on the technical side of the market. Let's get you some updates from the world of politics then. The dust is yet to settle on Karunanidhi's death, but it's a